what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to our Let's Replay series in Bioshock 2. We're still in Dionysus Park, and as a refresher, this park is owned by Sophia Lamb, and she is actually, something happened here, a terrible accident happened here that flooded the entire place and killed everybody in it during a busy party. Something closed the door, but I don't see anybody behind us, so let's keep going then, I suppose. Cohen's Collection. We kind of know that area, because this area has a lot in common with Fort Frolic. And therefore they also have an art gallery named Cohen's Collection, the same as in Fort Frolic. So let's follow the area we can go now, because it doesn't seem like we can go the normal route. And as you've probably seen the previous game, or played the previous game, that was a Houdini splicer. So the splicers that can teleport all over the place. But let's see if we can't whack him in the face. I'm gonna have to research those first if I want to have a bit of damage on them. Phosphorus buck, that might come in handy, so let's equip that. And just get the research camera going. Check all those. Yeah, thank you very much. And then a door code, which we don't have a keypad. That needs a door code to a part to the people station, but we can't really get there just yet. So let's hack this thing first. So we get a bit of an extra item. That was a very small area. There we go. First aid kit for us. Not for us immediately, but something at least. And then maybe the anti-personnel rounds. Yeah, drill fuel we have enough of. So let's see. Okay. Are you over there on the left or are you on the right? Nothing on the left. A corpse. With nothing of interest in there. Okay, hi. There she goes. Saw her really quickly, but... the one thing you need to... keep in mind regarding... yeah, there we go. Spider splices, Houdini splices, is that they actually don't teleport. They stay in... okay, hello. They stay in place for quite a while, and then you can kind of follow them around. So there we go, headshots do the trick. Because I still have the feeling that they move around and not teleport immediately.
And infiltrated Dionysus Park. His death is our rebirth. The life of the people's daughter is in your hands.
So the one thing I never really understood about Dionysus Park is this place was completely flooded for years. Why are there even splicers alive in this place? Because they wouldn't have been able to survive underwater this long. But never mind that. We're gonna just see that through our fingers and let that slip. Let that slip and slide. Let's see if we can find anything of use in here. A corpse, as they do in here. And spear ammo. We have plenty of spear ammo left, so that's not bad. But now, with the Headhunter tonic, by the way, headshots with spear ammo are incredibly powerful. They're also incredibly hard to pull off, but if you can, it's probably one of the best damage dealers you can have. Let's see if we can't... yeah, there's an audio diary over here. A gift from Billy. Who's Billy?
Dear Yellow Eye Girl, my name is Billy. And I saw you the other day at the merry-go-round. I think you are very pretty. And I like your blue dress and the songs you sing about angels. My mom says your dad is scary, but I think he is strong and nice, like a comic book hero. I got you a gift and put it in the basement, where nobody will find it. The secret code for the door is 1080. I hope you like it. I will wave to you next time I see you, so you know it's me.
So sorry I let you go through that, but that was Billy Parson, and the poor boy was actually in love with a little sister. We can only assume that that didn't work out so great, now did it? But that gave us the code to the Power to the People station over here, and a dead Big Daddy, dead bouncer. How fitting, right next to the present for the yellow-eyed girl. So let's check that out. And in there is a rose. There we go. A rose for a little sister. Upgrade the weapon. Let's see. I think we were going for the rivet gun heat upgrade, and I think we're still going to go for that. So an internal heating mechanism heats rivets to a white hot temperature before they are fired. May ignite living creatures on repeated shots. There we go, the heat upgrade. Lamp's time is over, and you got the trophy for fully upgraded weapon. Hooray!
I'm told that Lamb has been seen in the streets. One of the Alpha series was killed in the incident, and his bonded sister stolen. But the Council has no time for a manhunt. Atlas swells the ranks of his marauders by the day. Regardless, Lamb's name has already faded among the people. She is no more than a ghost who has forgotten to die.
But she was there, because the Alpha series that she's talking about was, of course, us. It was the beginning of the game, and I kind of missed another audio diary over here. Patronage.
Well, I'm in. Yep, yours truly is the newest member of the Rapture family. I fed Wales a line about how the Tribune was stopping me from telling the people what's what, and without a word, he hands me an invite to this artist's retreat here at the park. Lamb bought my frustrated novelist act. She's even sponsoring me to ink it while I'm here. Except, my story's all about her. And I don't think she's gonna like the way it ends.
So there we go. Stanley Poole was hired by Sinclair to, make Sophia Lamb look bad so they could have a reason to put her in jail. We don't know how, but he apparently succeeded, because we know Sophia eventually ended up in jail in the prison of Rapture. But yeah, we don't really know how he did that, but maybe we can find out, because apparently he gained access to this place. Why is my crosshair is red over there? Hello? What? Yeah, that was very... Very smart of you, sir. Cohen's collection, there we go.
Will you look at this hall? We're gonna be rich.
Okay. Oh my, yes. And I think if I now use the spear. Utterly
divine. Oh, bloody fucking die.
That was in your face. And that was in your face. And that was in your face. I do love Headhunter. That was nicely done. They just lined up to get shot in the face. No, I can't carry that other Eve. Hypo steam is coming out of the pipes here. This place is not in good shape. Let's check this out. Those are... trap spears. If I can get this one. Yeah, okay. And then, oh shit. Never mind. It was difficult to start off, but easier to go afterwards. There we go. And just normal 50 caliber rounds. Do we need anything? Might buy some phosphorus buck. Yeah, there we go. And let's go with the anti-personnel rounds for a second. And let's take a look around. Seems like there's... Hello. Thank you for those spears. There's another audio diary over here. Lamb's idea of art.
She knows precisely how I feel about this celebration of unconscious art. The artist reflects the world as it ought to be, not as it is damned to be by some spasm of the lower mind. I shall not censor. The park is Lamb's property. However, if the case we are building against her proves true, I will return with a sledgehammer.
So there we go. You might have heard that behind the door, but that was Mark Meltzer himself. the guy that came to Rapture to find his missing daughter. And it appears that he found her, but he's getting attacked by a big sister.
Well, the good news is I've located a new train car, but the station's still locked down and we're not alone in here. I see a shadow in the security booth. I'll lay low while you have a gander.
So Sinclair found another train card, but there's somebody in the booth and he doesn't know who it is.
Hello, boys. The name's Stan Poole, Rapture Tribune. Quality paper. Before the locals stopped reading and started finding other uses for it. Anyway, I'm looking to cut a deal, fellas. Come by the train station. I'm here in the booth.
And there we had the answer to that question immediately. Stanley Poole, the crooked journalist, is the one in the booth. Apparently still alive as well. So what he's doing here exactly, we don't know. But I guess he'll tell us in a minute. Let's see. There's another gatherer's garden over there. We don't see Mark Meltzer anymore, which is kind of sad. Because I wanna shake hands with the man. But, and then the merry-go-round. This is actually really cool. I really like this set piece right here, that merry-go-round. But the music is a bit annoying, because of course that's licensed music. And I don't want to have that in my recording. So, fuck off, please. Can I turn that off? Probably not. Or I can. Lost and found. There we go.
I found her. Found Cindy. By this rusted carousel. But she was just standing there. Staring. Waiting for the music. And she doesn't even recognize me. What have they done to her? Listen to her.
The man in the moon is a girl, Mr. Bubbles.
Listen, if anyone hears this, I have to know how to cure her. I... No! Get back! She's my little girl!
So there we go. That's the ending we heard. We heard that ending. But Mark Meltzer found his little girl. Found that she was turned into a little sister. And tries to help her, but he gets attacked by a big sister. Of course, guarding the little sisters as a whole. What's that? I see feet over there. I think they saw me.
Partners, we were partners. Sharing, like I said.
Oh, what the? There we go. That was weird. Kind of got stuck on a rock or something. Oh yeah, that thing
Dionysus
in the middle of the statue.
Was my home, Delta. An experiment in social unity, cut short by human folly. You dishonor its memory with every step.
Cut short by human folly.
Now that, see, Lamb knows you're here, but I'm incognito. Thing is, since you drained out the park, the little sisters are already starting to nose around, looking for Adam, and I can't have that.
I can't have the little sisters nosing around for Adam. That is a weird notion. Why would you mind? Solid slug. Solid slug shotgun ammo does anti-personnel damage and penetrates multiple soft targets. So even better against normal people.
Hey, Sasha! Crack the safe already! I want my goddamn toy to fry!
Wow, this thing is accurate. Holy shit. And there we go, double spear to the face. That kind of fixed that already. And there's another power to the people station. These are coming closer and closer together. Okay, searched again and I found nothing instead of the filled loot in there. I think I'm gonna start throwing away the scrounger tonic. But let's upgrade this again. The shotgun Tesla upgrade. That is actually an interesting one as well. So now we can do shock damage with the shotgun as well. So that's really, really, really awesome. Let's hack this thing. There we go. And then a blue one, green one, green one. Okay, that's nothing. Get the drill fuel, maybe the solid slugs, and there we go. Let's go back to the solid slugs. And auto hack this lovely thingy. 4 solid slugs, $47, and 44 armor piercing rounds. It's fine by me. Anything behind here doesn't seem like it. Let's go back to the minigun. And let's see. Splicers, hello. Is that an explosive barrel? I might actually take that with me. Yep. A-O. Yeah, I think it was an explosive barrel. You dead? Think you are, okay. Didn't mean to jump there. Apparently the game decided to jump for me and I fired accidentally. Okay, hello?
Take this, father, and hurry. Mother can't hear this, but she's looking right at me. And her face.
Mother can't hear this, but she's looking right at me. So that confirms that Eleanor is talking to us telepathically, not actually talking. But this lovely, lovely baby is ours. The launcher. Of course we're gonna get another grenade launcher. What did you think? But this thing looks a hell of a lot more like a rocket launcher than the grenade launcher from the previous game. Which kind of looks like more of a bunch of parts jumbled together. But this one is really, 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 really awesome. Kind of looks like, yeah, and even with the steam and everything. Really nice design. I really like this thing just by the looks of it. Where did we actually... Yeah, we came from over here. So now we need to go around. And I don't think there are any splicers around. But just in case there are, I'm going to grab this explosive barrel. Oh, they are. Hi. Can I hack this thing now? Doesn't look like it's such a good idea, but yeah. There we go. You find double ammo on destroyed machines. Actually got us something. This is the train, so this is where Sinclair just hid inside, and now we have a little talk with Stanley Poole.
Okay, so dead men tell no tales, right? Wrong. See, with Adam involved, every stiff's got a story, and Lamb knows how to read it. If that stuff makes it back to her, I'm an obituary. So, I want you to take the story of Dionysus Park and bury it. Get rid of the little sisters for me. Your way. Do that, and I'll unlock the station here. Scout's honor.
So, yeah.
Well,
I'm gonna let Sinclair talk
first.
He's
hiding something, but he sort of took the fun out of that one. He's locked in the security booth, however, so we'll have to play along. Find those sisters.
Is somebody else gonna pitch in, or can I talk now? Okay, so Stanley Poole. This lovely, lovely man over here. It's clear that he has something to do with the flooding of Dionysus Park. He realizes that the little sisters can bring back the memories from the dead. Because, of course, I explained this in the previous series, but Adam contains the genetic memories of everything it inhabits at one time. So, oh, I can actually enter this place. So even if you're dead, your genetic memories are stored in the Adam you have in your body. So if the little sisters extract the Adam, technically they should be able to get that memory to somewhere else. So in this case, Fialam is able to read those memories, which of course would be bad for Stanley. So, okay, there was another Houdini splicer, I think. So Stanley Poole asks us to get rid of all the little sisters so Lam can get her hands on the Adam and the memories, of course, of... Hello? Okay, that was done immediately. So if she teleports, I lose my research. That is kind of bullshit. Never mind, let's hack this thing. Okay. And green. And green again. Ooh, heavy rivets. Thank you. Maybe a bit more anti-personnel rounds. I have the money. I mean, it's best that we are fully supplied. Let's see if I can take another picture of this lovely spider. No spider splicer. Houdini splicers. We need to research the Houdini splicer. Looks like we could actually run underneath here, but I don't think there's much here aside from that Eve hypo. No, okay, never mind. I said nothing. So yeah, Dionysus Park was flooded by Stanley Poole for some reason. So we don't know why he did it, and we don't know how exactly it came to be. This guy seems to be dead. Anything else? Because this is really cool. I might actually talk a bit about this level as well. Originally, the developers were planning to make this the most pristine level of the game. So everything was designed to be impeccable, so perfect, untouched by the damage done to the rest of the city. So it would be the most clean level of all. But then they turned that idea around to its complete opposite extreme and turned it into a flooded area with a very interesting story to boot. So let's see. This is the main hub area, kind of. So I'm kind of looking around if there's no splicers in the neighborhood. Doesn't seem like there is. So let's head over here first. And we enter the promenade. A lovely, lovely lounge bar, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, a burning splicer passes the frame. And then let's take care of this guy. And then let's shock the man. And I think I'm gonna put a spear in his face. Or nope. There we go. That was in his face. Got the spears and give me that first aid kit as well. Thank you very much. Quickly gonna use an Eve Hypo here so I'm full up on everything. And maybe start using those solid slugs because those pack a punch as well. Could have drunk a... Okay. That's a lot of... What the... Hi! What the hell? So that's Big Sister confirming that she can teleport. Kind of in the same way that the Houdini splicers can do that. And this piano is playing on its own. Okay then. Truth is in the body.
Awareness of self is no miracle, Eleanor. It is a trick of the gene. An endless inner refrain asking, what's in it for me? To serve the world, we must grow deaf to the self. Are you ready? Now, stop listening to my voice. Stop listening. Stop. Difficult, isn't it? Human verbal cues are defensive coloration, camouflage. Play this recording until you no longer hear the words. Then you may observe the people for who they are.
You're not okay. And there we go. So that was another audio diary of Sophia Lamb training her daughter into, stealing her mind. It's the easiest way of putting that. Did you see, by the way, what those solid slugs did to those two poor splicers in front of the door? Because they were opening the door. So this is the piano bar. We're back at the center area with the merry-go-round. But now we can actually enter this place. What was that? Saw something, probably fish. Must have been fish. Hello? Hello? What's this? Money and frag grenades. That is very nice of you. Very nice indeed. And then we enter this very long winded area. And I think I'm gonna just use a spear to take out one of those splicers. Probably the left one over here. Hello there. Is this thing silent as well? Hi. There you go. That was a lovely noise. There we go. And then the J. Fisher Gallery. Then we have also this area to the left. Filled with ice. And you might have noticed already, we haven't found any little sisters yet. But I think behind this door is one of them. They kind of arranged this level differently. Just because they kind of forced you to go and find them. Since it's all about the little sisters in this level. Let's see, can I hit the camera from over here? That was... Nope, that was on it. There we go. Green, there we go. And then the one on the right here. I think there's a turret over there as well, yeah. And then we can hack the turret really quickly, give us a bit more research. That camera apparently doesn't see all the way over here, so can I photograph that thing? Yeah, I can. And there we go, a bee. That was not that great, actually. Is there anything else? I think there's another camera over here. But I can hide away from it and just put myself underneath and hack it manually. There's an enemy triggered. I think it's for the turret over there. There we go. A plus on security. Just grinding that out a bit since it's one of the only research tables that I'm still needing. Okay, that might have been a bit too much. There we go. Let's electrocute it and then let's manually hack this lovely turret. There we go. Just in time before he shot me in the face. Now then. So this is a big frozen area with a lot of security measures. Kind of reminding me of the arena where we fought. How was it? Peach Wilkins. In the previous game. I don't need any of that. Just hack it. Pretty tough. Pick up the first aid kit. Heal and then smack this thing to pieces. And give us another health kit. Because I really, really need it right now. Blast a few of the corners just in case there's any good loot in the corners under the ice, which sometimes there is. Is this? No, that's not a filing cabinet, so let's get back up. Because I think we should be able to find our first big daddy around here somewhere. Oh! Are you a real one? Doesn't seem like you are a real one, but you look frozen though. So sometimes they can do this really, really creepily. So there's two types of ice. There's the ice you can melt, and then there's ice you can't melt for some reason with a flaming ball of fire. Really, really weird, but apparently that's how this level works. Not much going on in this level, apparently. Just ending it with hardy machines. A hack turret or bot can be your greatest friend. Well, very fitting in this room. Make that friendship last longer with the new hardy machines tonic from Ryan Industries. You know what? I'm gonna just swap that out with Scrounger. A mini turret, definitely gonna pick that up, although I can't. And then proximity mines, finally they're back. They're put way, way late in the game in this in Bioshock 2, especially if you compare it to Bioshock 1, where you get proximity mines as soon as Neptune's bounty. So that's the kind of the second level of the game. This guy's still frozen. No, oh, come on. And there we go. Easy to predict, Houdini's. Wow, she flew to the other side of the room. Thank you very much. Don't have Scrounger anymore, so I don't need to take care of that anymore as well. Can I? Damn it. Yeah, just, you know, I'm gonna... Add another frag grenade to the middle there. That was interesting. They exploded. Was that what I think it was? Yeah, hi. Jesus Christ, dude. Yeah, just leave him over there and just die because of the turrets and everything. Yep, goodbye. And let's drill him to pieces if the turret doesn't kill me first. God damn it, turret. Shoot at the splicers, not at me. So, dead guys. These guys aren't dropping any health kits, it appears. Is there something over here? No, never mind. Never mind. So, that's the frozen hellhole, apparently. I thought there would be more. Maybe there's a corpse for the little sisters. And then the big daddy must be over here.
There okay. She is. Get her. I hope that bodyguard ain't one of your long lost.
Oh, wow. There we go. Headshots taken care of easily. And now it... Is that a camera over here? Yeah, it is. Oh shit, that's gonna be a problem. Auto hack darts for the win. Okay, then next up, I'm gonna have to take care that this bouncer doesn't brutally murder me. So let's do this, and then that. Let's put a mini turret down, and oh shit, he's awake again. Let's go around the corner. Empty a whole can of phosphorus buck on this guy's head. Swap to the rocket spears and get a few in his ass. There we go. Oh. Timeout. I need timeout. That's true. That's true. I think. Oh, that's the end of the research period, it appears. There we go. Whew. Okay. Hey, little girl, where are you? Yeah, there she is. Okay. Hi.
Dad,
hi.
Are you taking me home too?
Yes, I am gonna take you home eventually, but first you're gonna have to do some work for me. But get on top of my shoulders. Yeah, I love you too. Here we go.
Smart. See? You put it to work, and all that atom ends up in you. But you're sort of a silent partner. So that's tops with me.
So yeah, indicating that I shouldn't talk about the memories, I will see if I take the atom into my body. Let's see, another first aid kit. And then a frag grenade, always handy. Let's hack this lovely machine. And I'm not gonna get an extra item, sadly, but checking this out nonetheless. Proximity mines could be handy, but I'm not gonna use those just yet. So yeah, never mind. Good to have hacked it anyway, but let's take a look around. Is there, I know there's a corpse there, but I want to just check the end of this room here first. Sounds like there's another camera close by, but it might be in the other room because the freezer is not right next door here. So that wouldn't be too weird. Gas canister, another Eve hypo, thank you very much, needed that immediately. And then the drill specialist tonic. Who needs guns when you've got the drill and nearly unlimited plasmid power? Significantly decreases cost of plasmids, but limits weapon selection to the drill, hack tool, and camera. This is one of the most powerful drill, tonics, that's what I want to say, tonics in the game, if you play it correctly. So you don't spend that much EVE on using plasmids, but you can only use the drill, the hack tool, and the camera. So yeah, I'm not going to use that just yet, but I might give it a try in one of the later levels. So yeah, thank you very much, but we're not going to do that just yet. And of course, a lot of drill fuel. Gotta keep it together.
So, Ryan's goons are sweating me to prove this place is a closet commune. But I need time. Lamb's kid keeps staring me down like she knows that I'm a phony. I keep thinking of Johnny Topside, though. It took real guts to find Rapture like he did. It makes it easier not to crack if I sort of imagine that I'm him. It's a good thing I can't tell Lamb that, though. She'd probably say I got a secret need to fall into his arms and make a wild whoopee or something.
So two things that were very interesting in that audio diary. One, Lamb's kid is keeping an eye on me. So Eleanor knew that Stanley Poole was not in the neighborhood of her mother for good reasons. And the other thing, he talked about Johnny Topside, a man he looked up to as some sort of idol. Someone who came to Rapture afterwards, and it took quite some guts to get here. Let's take all that. Just gonna check out the trap rivets over here. Because they'll probably... Okay, that's not what I wanted to do, but... How the hell... He's coming from behind us. What? How the hell did you even get there? And there we go. Rivet set people on fire now. So that's very nice as well. So that actually happens with the trap rivets as well. Ooh, that one's a bit crooked. Okay. But you know what? I'm going to take a little break before we do this gather. So when we get back, we're going to, well, start out with a little gather right here. And we're going to continue exploring Dionysus Park. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel. Because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye. Yeah,